Oh, Lee Roper. Hey, I just got to be honest. I had dinner with you last night.
Sure.
Had a great time.
Yep.
Got to see a little bit of the college town where you guys are. Mm-hmm. How far were we from campus last
20
night?
20 minutes.
20 minutes.
Oh, no. Last night?
Yeah, last night.
Right around the corner.
It was right there.
Right there.
What was the place across the street? It's got like a Panther name to it.
Oh, the Panther Lounge.
The Panther Lounge.
It's been there a while.
We felt like the Panther Lounge probably wasn't an appropriate place for us to go.
Not my scene.
Not our scene. That's good. We got to go back and got to eat some wings, yep. Calzone. It was good. Good food. Where were we? I forget.
Mulligan's
is good.
Yeah. They support a lot of what we do, man. We love that place.
In looking at it, this is C3, the third one they've done. You and Cliff started Compound together and, you know, ran the club. Now you're a college coach.
Right.
What is this like for you? I know you like go back to Georgia and do it. What's it like to be able to have 15 minutes down the road?
It's great because of the short drive. I get to go sleep in my bed at night. But other than that, it's the same, man. Those guys, the philosophy doesn't change no matter what they do. They kind of carry passion and energy around with them wherever they go. If it's in Georgia, if it's in Iowa, if it's in Washington State, man, it's going to be the same for them because they believe in what they preach. Their product's going to be the most important. They're trying to put out a great service for these kids, and it's beneficial for us too, and that's why we make sure we're there.
And looking at it, you're going to be doing this afternoon session. I always like the energy. You and John Reeder and Schwab, I feel like I want to harness you guys almost like the Matrix and like use your energy to like light my house or something. Fuel my car. I don't know, man.
It might be another job for me. That'd
it's
be good.
Pretty crazy, yeah, though. But like you guys, the amount of output, I don't know how a kid can't be, you know, excited to have this guy as a clinician. And you're in a tough spot, too. You personally. This is the last round, man. This is their, like, ninth workout.
Yeah, I actually asked to be last in this one. One, I like the challenge, too. And I've been at those sessions where it's the last one. The kids are kind of dragging. So I'm going to really try and put some passion in there because for me, Zeb, that's the most important thing in anything you do. Yeah, the technique I'm going to show, I really believe in. It's going to be some great stuff. But, man, technique doesn't win you matches. It's an ingredient. It's a small one. But whatever you do, if you want to be successful, you have to have that passion behind it. And that's what I try and communicate to these kids. That's the reason I coach. I want to fight being normal. I want to fight being average. I want these kids to really strive to be that 1%. Because that's kind of taken out of our society a little bit. It's like play it safe, be part of the group, get by, jump through the hoops, do all those things. And you get this at the end. I want those kids to really strive to be the best, and you have to emulate it if you want the kids to do it too. So I'm going to get all fired up and jacked up for the session, and hopefully they follow suit.
Energy drink, Mountain Dew, any of that, or just pure passion?
Oh, some caffeine's always involved for me, Zeb. Coffee, energy drink, whatever it takes. I'm trying to get off the energy drinks. You told me how bad they were at the last one.
It's really bad.
So I've been weaning off. I'm taking care of my kidneys better, drinking more water, and I've gone like the more natural coffee and espresso route. So
I like it.
I've been listening to you on that. I'm trying to do a little bit better.
The energy drinks, I told you, my doctor's like, it will kill you, literally.
I'm trying to wean them off, man, and only if I can't get my hands on coffee will I put one down.
In looking at the vision, you know, Doug was here yesterday, the vision for the program,
right.
The passion you guys both deliver to it, and being involved in something special, what are you guys looking for and as far as the UNI Panther here recruiting?
Well, it all goes back to what Doug really believes in, man. We kind of got three tenets on our team. We've got our system and the things we believe in, but it's a little bit different. It's not a technique system like some places have. Our system's about personality and characteristic traits. Our first one is you have to be selfless. Nobody gets where they are in life by themselves. You always get more return to you when you give back. So that's the first thing we always preach to our guys is be selfless. And that's why Doug insists we come give our time other places. The technique we get, we have to go give it with other teams, whether it's here or down the road, Southwest Iowa or down in Georgia. We got to go give back what we learn. The other thing's hard work and work ethic. Nobody got where they're at without working hard, so that's the other thing he asked us to do. When we come in here, we give us every single thing we got and then be solution-focused. We don't want to focus on problems. We don't want to point the finger at the other person. We always want to come up with how we're going to move forward ourselves. So that's what we're going to try and communicate, and that's why Doug comes in and tries to kill it, and Randy's here scouting and trying to find the best guys, and why I'm going to try and kill it in this session too.
All right. It's about to go down here soon. You got anything else for me?
No, man, I appreciate what you do. You always got great questions. I'm going to stare at the camera just to make you mad there at the end. Zeb always tells me, look at my eyes, not the camera. So I love what you do, Zeb. I appreciate the interviews. Best guy in the game.